Welcome to edupediaworld.com. In today's video, we will learn about soil pollution. We're going to talk about what is soil pollution. Then thereafter, we will discuss the causes of soil pollution, impacts of soil pollution, and we will also talk about some of the remedies of soil pollution. So what is soil pollution? Soil pollution means contamination of soil. This contamination of soil can be due to any waste, that is the waste which comes out of the industries, the waste which comes out of the agriculture. So any kind of pollution, any kind of contamination to the soil is known as soil pollution. As you see here, this picture, you see these are the landfills. So basically landfills also create soil pollution, right? So this contamination that you see here may be due to household waste or may be due to industrial waste, right? So what is soil pollution? Soil pollution is the contamination of soil with solid waste, with acid rain. It may be because of acid rain. Excess of fertilizers, that is the waste from the agriculture, insecticides and herbicides is called as the soil pollution, right? And what happens because of continuous soil pollution? The soil may become something like this. The soil may become infertile. Right. Now let's discuss the causes of soil pollution. Main cause of soil pollution is deforestation. What is deforestation? Deforestation is removal or cutting down of the trees or the forest. That is called as deforestation. Right. So what happens in deforestation? Once they cut down all the trees, the soil erosion takes place. That is because there are no more trees to hold the soil tightly to the ground. So when it rains, the soil is just washed away from this area, and this is known as soil erosion. The soil becomes loose, right? So this deforestation, the soil erosion, is the main cause of soil pollution because this washes away all the important nutrients from the soil, right? So next is irrigation. What is irrigation? Irrigation is supplying the water to the crops or to the fields. But what happens when irrigation, some wrong practices are used for irrigation, similar things happen. This is what you see. This are the waterlogging condition. What happens when we supply water in very, very large quantity than is actually required for the crop? Waterlogging conditions persist. And because of this water, the passage of air to the crop or to the field, it stops because of water. Air cannot be passed. Air cannot be supplied to the crop. And because of this, the growth of the crop stops. Quality of the crop will be very, very bad. And this, over a long period of time, this makes the area barren. It loses its fertility. So the farmers should know what are the right practices of irrigation. Now let's move ahead. Landfills. Landfills are another way to cause soil pollution. There is a lot of waste. This waste comes out of mainly the houses, the household waste. This makes the landfill. So these waste also pollute the soil. The agricultural waste, that is the use of toxic fertilizers and pesticide, they also become a main cause of soil pollution. Why these days the farmers are using these toxic fertilizers and pesticide? That is because with the increase in the population, the demand for the food has increased over a period. Now, because of the increase in the demand, the crop supply is still the same. The agricultural land will remain the same, but the demand for the food has increased. In that short period of time, over that available land, more and more quantity of food is required to be produced. And that is why these days the farmers are going in for these toxic fertilizers and pesticide so that the crop can be produced at a much faster rate. But they do not understand that it has very bad and long-term side effects. Because what it leads to? It leads to contamination and poisoning of soil. When we consume such a crop, then even we get contaminated. Over a long period of time, this has a very, very harmful effect on the human body. So what is the solution for this? The solution is that the farmers should go in for some biofertilizers, right? Okay, mining is another cause for soil pollution, and there are a lot of harmful gases also. There are a lot of harmful elements which comes out of a mine, which poses a hazard on the human body also. There are some metals like cadmium and lead which are very, very toxic, and when they come out of the earth's surface, then they contaminate the soil, right? And the land, as you see here, this is how the land where the mining is done looks like. So the entire land now becomes barren because of such harmful chemicals which are coming out, such harmful metals which are coming out. The next cause of soil pollution is soil erosion. So this we spoke when we were discussing about deforestation. Now, why does soil erosion occur? How does it happen? When there is rain and there are no trees, the soil is loose. So the entire soil get washed away along with the water, right? And with this soil, a lot of good nutrients which are required for good quality crop are also washed along with the water. That is why it affects the quality of crop. That is why, because now there are no nutrients left in the soil to produce good quality crop, the quality of the crop will be down. The quality of the crop will be bad. This is what is called as soil erosion. So soil erosion leads to loss of fertile land for agriculture. It leads to, you know, loss of forest cover and also patches for grazing. That is grazing for the animals, the cattle, right? So that is what is known as the soil erosion, which is also one of the cause for soil pollution. Okay, next is acid rain. Acid rain also pollutes soil. What is acid rain? See, acid rain, it is also a product of the waste that comes out of the industries, right? So these are the industries, and the gases, the harmful gases that comes out of the industries are sulfur dioxide. These are nitrogen oxides. So the basically sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxides are the two gases which are very, very harmful, and these are what comes out of the industries. So when these acidic gases are released in the atmosphere, these gases are carried by the wind, and then they become clouds here. So now these clouds contain these harmful gases. Ultimately, when the precipitation, when it rains, then these harmful gases are dissolved in rainwater, and when it falls on the surface of the earth, then this is what is called as acid rain. Acid rain can kill the plants, they can pollute the rivers, the streams, right? So this is how the acid rain is very, very harmful. So acid rain is also the main cause for soil pollution. So now we're going to talk about impacts of soil pollution. Till now we have talked about what is soil pollution and what causes the soil pollution. Now, because of these causes, what happens? What are the impacts of soil pollution? So the first impact is change in climatic patterns. Now, we have been seeing that because of acid rain, the life that lives on Earth's surface and even the marine life which lives in the water, everything gets affected. Everything has a harmful effect on their body if they are exposed to such kind of acid rain and such kind of contamination for a long period of time. So neither the land nor water nor the air, nothing is pure. Everything is contaminated. So this kind of pollution is ultimately changing our climate. The climatic patterns are changing. Why? Because the entire ecosystem is changing. The entire ecosystem is contaminated. So that is what I mean when I say change in climatic condition. Next and major impact is impact on the human health. What is the impact on the human health? When the land gets contaminated, there are a lot of toxic chemicals and pesticides which enters the soil. So when we human beings or the animals, when they eat such crop or such agricultural product, then even those chemical, harmful chemicals get into their body, and over a period of time they will have some harmful effects. They may have a skin problem, they may have respiratory problem if we keep consuming such harmful crop. It starts from a very, very minor problems and then it leads to major problems. We have air pollution continuously, we have water pollution, we also have soil contamination, right? Now, because of air pollution, generally we have problems in respiration. And water pollution will have a lot of disease like, you know, typhoid and a lot of bacteria and parasites and other chemicals that are entering in our body. So then again, because of soil pollution, we end up consuming harmful pesticides in our body. So we have problems like skin irritation, nausea, cancer risk, gastroenteritis, and cardiovascular illness, respiratory problems. So all these three, that is all the pollution, the soil pollution, the water pollution, and the air pollution, all together causes the headache, fatigue, right? So if we are exposed to such a contamination for a long period of time, then it has a very, very harmful effect on the human health. So next is impact on the environment. With deforestation, the trees are cut down and the tree cover is also compromised. So when there are no trees, there are two things which tend to happen. First is that soil erosion will take place, that is, the top layer of the soil will be washed away. And second thing is that it imbalances the rain cycle. Because of no trees, there won't be any more rains, right? And with this imbalance, there are other imbalances in the nature which will happen. For example, the global warming, the greenhouse effect, irregular rainfalls, and increase in floods. So these are few more imbalances which tend to happen if deforestation continues. Next impact is distraction for tourists. Now just imagine there is one city which is neat and it is known for its beautification. On the other hand, there is another city which is full of landfills and it is polluted because of air pollution, dirty water everywhere, landfills everywhere, and dirty environment. So which one do you think that the tourist would like to visit? Definitely not which is full of landfills and it has pollution everywhere. Tourists generally gets attracted to a city which is neat and clean and it is beautiful. So because of soil pollution, such cities loses its attraction as tourist destination due to the pollution everywhere. And as the tourist would reduce because of pollution, this leads to loss of revenue for the government also. And hence, on the other hand, even the city loses its attraction and revenue too. So distraction for tourists is also another impact of soil pollution. So now we talked about impact of soil pollution on human health, but it is not just the human health which is affected because of soil pollution, but even the wildlife is affected. And how are they affected? Let's say if any animal is drinking a water and this water is polluted because of pollution, then the animal will have harmful effects on his body after a long period, right? The animal might shift to a new location where he could find drinkable water and safe environment to stay. So this soil pollution also leads to lot of loss of habitat and natural environment. There are some of the species that are almost coming to an end. They are almost extinct now. That is the real cause, the actual cause for their extinction is also pollution. Most of the animals and the kettles and the other marine life, they die because of a lot of contamination in the water or on the land. So the soil pollution may also lead to death of any animal or the wildlife. So these are some of the impacts of soil pollution on the wildlife. Now, we talked about various imbalances in nature, and one of those imbalances we spoke was global warming. Soil pollution leads to global warming. And why? What is global warming? Is global What is global warming? Global warming is the increase in the amount of carbon dioxide in the environment around the surface of the earth. And the main cause for this global warming is pollution. So the ratio of the carbon dioxide and oxygen, the balance between the oxygen and the CO2 is again imbalanced. And this increase in the CO2 gives rise to very, very high temperatures, right? So this is called as global warming. This rise in the temperature actually leads to global warming, which is not a safe environment to stay in. Next is biomagnification. What is biomagnification? It is the transfer of the harmful chemicals from one body to another body. Let's say, as we see here, we have a food chain, which is shown over here. Smallest organism to the largest organism, the chemicals are transferred because the primary producer is consumed by the zooplanktons. The zooplanktons are eaten by small fishes. The small fishes are eaten by the large fish, and thereafter they are eaten by the eagle or the tertiary consumer. So this way, these harmful chemicals that were initially present in the water, they are consumed and they are transferred to the tertiary level here, right? So this is called as biomagnification. The discharge of chemicals on the land, this makes it dangerous for the ecosystem. So it is basically the transfer of these harmful chemicals from one level in the food chain to the other level. So now let's just discuss the various remedies of soil pollution. How can we reduce soil pollution? First and foremost is that people have to be aware about the concept of, you know, reuse, recycle and reduce. This concept we have talked about in the earlier videos also. Only if people are aware about this concept, they will be able to effectively use the products which are eco-friendly, and they will be able to avoid such products which are non-biodegradable, like the plastic, right? And also the awareness should be about, you know, what are the causes of soil pollution, how can it affect our human health and our ecosystem. So only if this awareness spreads among people, they will be more cautious towards the soil pollution. So next solution is garbage disposal. That is, what do we mean by garbage disposal? That is disposing of the garbage. First of all, the garbage has to be disposed of properly. In case there is any litter which is lying outside our house or nearby area surrounding, then if it is lying in open, then it has to be picked up and disposed of properly in proper garbage bins. Secondly, we have to create dumping grounds. That is, these dumping grounds should have a specific place where the entire garbage is to be dumped. Now also we see that in most of the localities, they make a dumping ground wherein the garbage from each house is picked up and it is dumped in that area, right? So this is how proper dumping grounds has to be created for garbage. Faulty sanitation practices must be improved. That is, in case in like in earlier days, we have seen people are used to go and in open fields for sanitation. So those practices nowadays have almost stopped, but still we see that in villages and other rural areas, people are still following the same sanitation practices. This has to stop. The toilets have to be constructed. In this picture, as we have seen, people are using proper plastic bag, which are the garbage bags, and then they are picking up the garbages, putting in these plastic bags, and then these plastic bags will be thrown in proper dumping grounds. So that is how the practice has to set in. Also, we see that different kinds of these bins are used for various garbages. Like if it is a paper, then it has to be thrown in a separate bin. If it is glass, it is plastic, because plastic is again non-biodegradable, and then metal. But these are generally done in hospitals and other industries. But at home, what we can do is that we can separate the dry and the wet waste. Two bins has to be used. One bin should be for dry waste and the other bin should be for wet waste. The wet waste may be used to produce or create manure, which can be used in fields and other agricultural practices. So this way we have to know good practices of garbage disposal. This is very important, and we have reiterated this point in our previous videos also. Do not use plastic, because plastics are non-biodegradable, they cannot be recycled, and also they are not eco-friendly. So we have to say no to plastic. Again, waste management, it is almost equal to what we discussed about garbage management. But garbage management is mostly out of the houses. Waste management, this here we are talking about the waste which comes out of the industry. Proper treatment of the liquid waste which comes out of the industry and mines, this must be done. When this water or these kinds of waste, when they are added to the natural water resources, then they make these water resources dirty. There is a lot of pollution that is created because of these liquid waste. So before the liquid waste from the industry and mines comes out and it mixes with the natural resources, it has to be cleaned properly. Liquid waste treatment of plants has to be done. Very, very important is to grow trees. The more number of trees we grow, the more healthy and safe and pure will be the air around us, will be the environment and the ecosystem. We have to avoid deforestation and start growing more and more number of trees in our area, in our locality. So each one of us has to take this initiative of growing more and more trees. If we cut one tree, we have to plant, let's say, two trees. So that's how we are going to make our ecosystem healthy and green. As far as the agricultural waste is concerned, we talked about the toxic fertilizers and pesticides that the farmers generally use in the fields. So these toxic fertilizers have to be stopped, and we have to make use of biofertilizers and natural pesticides so that they are not harmful. And when such a crop is eaten by the human beings or by the animals, then those toxic chemicals will not be transferred. It will, because these are biofertilizers. So we need to shift to biofertilizers and reduce the use of pesticide and fertilizers which are toxic in the agricultural practices. So what is important here is to note that when we talk about agriculture, so we should not look for only the short-term goals, so that, you know, the crop will be, the production of the crop will be faster, the production of the crop will be in a greater quantity, because if that is our goal, then the farmers will use a lot of toxic fertilizers. But in this case, we have to look for long-term goals, like whether it will have any impact on the human life over a period of time, whether it will have an impact on the wildlife. So this way, if we study about each and every field, and if we study about the soil pollution, then can we have a very, very safe environment and a safe ecosystem. So for anything, whatever we study, we have to look for its long-term goals rather than looking for the short-term goals, right? Here, what is important is the soil pollution can be reduced only if we look at our long-term goals rather than the short-term goals. So I hope you must have understood what is soil pollution, what are the causes of soil pollution, and what are the after effects of soil pollution, the effects on human health, on the wildlife, on the climate, and thereafter on the ecosystem. In the next video, we will talk about air pollution, water pollution. So thank you for watching Edupedia World Videos.